Prime Minister.
Opposition leader Alan Chastanet continues to urge Prime Minister Philippe Jean-Pierre to take immediate action to protect the credibility of the country's CIP. During a televised speech, which he labeled an open letter to the nation's leader, he outlined his concerns regarding the accusations stemming from the MSR Media RICO lawsuit. Chastanet reiterated a call for the removal of the investment minister and the CEO of the CIP unit, in addition to the current board members who are implicated. He also called for the suspension of Caribbean Galaxy as a marketing agent of the infrastructure option and halting of applications from the same until an independent audit is completed.
Instead of personal attacks and racial slurs on me and the United Workers' Party, you should direct reprimands, investigations, and terminations towards those who are responsible for this most egregious scandal. This problem will not go away by ignoring it and protecting the wrongdoers based on blind party loyalty. This situation has presented you with a dilemma in choosing between party and country. This is a test of your leadership. Rather than hiding behind the refrain that you will not make further comment on this scandal until the RICO case is concluded, the public is owed an immediate explanation.
Referencing the recent address by the investment minister, Dr. Ernest Hilaire, on the status of the CIP, Chastanet pointed out that there are still many questions that the minister did not address.
Instead of addressing these serious issues, your government has instead, in typical fashion, chosen the course of misdirection and deflection, and preferred to make a pathetic and weak attempt to connect me to the MSR Media claim. The fact is, I never heard of this company, nor its principal, Philip Martinez, until April of this year, when he also attempted to contact you about evidence he has in his possession, re-appending court matter.
Chastanet believes that the allegations hanging over the CIP are serious enough that if not addressed properly could have implications for the country. In his statement, he announced possible legal action against the government if the Prime Minister does not respond to his concerns.
Prime Minister, if you do not take action, we'll be left with no other option but to take this matter to the courts and to solicit the support of civil society and the public to prevent further threats to the integrity of our CIP program and our country as a whole.
For the DBS Newsworld, I am Zane Romulus.